Hi, this is Sharon from Rhythm Station, and you're listening to Classic 21. Now, we did think up front of how we wanted to sound like, but it's not always the same. Like, what you think of up front is not always how it's going to end up in the end, of course. But what we exactly what you said, like, what we wanted to do is make our kind of music that we make as Rhythm Station sound more like 2019 instead of like, you know, you want to go along with your time. So the use of certain kind of elements like urban style kind of music into our music does make it more modern in a way and up to date to our opinion. And that's what we did aim for. But you never know. It's sometimes difficult to find the right balance between all these different styles, because you don't want to sound like an urban band, which is very cool, but it's not who we are. So it's very delicate, thin line to find the right balance. Well, you know, when I started as a little girl, I actually I fell in love with the voice of Olivia Newton-John. That's how I started, but I was 4 years old, and I still enjoy her voice a lot, so I like a lot of country music. That's how I started, and after that it was Dolly Parton, actually. And then I got into high school, and I got to go and I met all these guys who were listening to different kind of music, and my parents were also listening to all kinds of music. And I loved Queen, and I always heard him sing so many different ways, and but also Deep Purple, and that's what I grew up with. And then when I got in high school, I met girls and boys who were listening to Tori Amos and Nirvana. And Nirvana was really my biggest passion, because he was so, the band was so pure and in every form possibly.
It's really raw.
Yeah, really raw. And so I had, vocally, I had different people I looked up to, not always females, but also men. And I think if you put everything in the blender with my own, what I'm able to do with my voice, you get what I'm doing now. It's my, some flavors of country is there sometimes, and but also at a certain time, I also listened to Mariah Carey, for instance, because she was technically the best vocalist ever, like Steve Vai on guitars, and was like, okay, how high can I go? Drove my parents crazy, because I was always trying to sing that very, very high notes. So that's where how I trained my voice, and yeah. But I also felt like what was important is stay close to your emotions, and that's what you want to reflect when you're singing. It's like, okay. Yeah, I did a solo project called My Indigo, which is totally different from Rhythm Station, and that was something that I needed to do for myself. After Haida, I was worn out. Really tired of everything, and I've been in my whole adult life in this band. So for me, it was time to take a break and to see, you know, I've been doing this for 23 years almost. It's like, do I still want to continue in this way? Because the tours are heavy. It's always a long time from home. And everybody has families nowadays, not just the band, but also crew. And to keep everyone together, because also crew, we try to keep throughout time always the same, because we have such a good vibe with each other. But then you need to take in consideration that sometimes you need a break a little bit longer than you normally do. And for me, my dad got really sick, so I really wanted to take time off from my parents and to be with them while this whole process of getting sick was going on. And I needed to reflect on my past. I needed to deal with certain things. That's why My Indigo came on my path, because it was something different than Rhythm Station, and the emotions I was feeling was not something I could put in Rhythm Station. So I felt like I do this as a solo project, and it took me some time. I didn't know if I was going to come back to Rhythm Station again either, because I didn't know if the change was enough for me just to do this solo project, or that I needed to do this for a longer period, or maybe forever. But we're here now with a new album.
And we're glad. Yeah.
I'm glad too, yeah. It's about now, but also what's to come. And also looking back a little bit on the past, how things have turned out today because of the past. And I'm talking about When I grew up as a kid, I was playing on this Commodore 64 on floppy with floppy disks and games and stuff. And I never thought that internet and social media would ever be what it's now today. We didn't know the existence. It developed throughout time, and which is a good thing because we love development. That's also why we could get in contact with Jacoby on the other side of the pond, and you know, send files and stuff. It goes so easy nowadays, and also programs. It's all very nice, but the downside of this development is the fact that it went so quickly that we didn't catch up with privacy laws and those kind of things. And in the future, I think already now, I think it can turn against you. In certain countries, already happens, like that governments are, you know, checking on people with face recognition where you've been, and you know, if you want to, if you live in China, it's not the best place with this technology, for instance. Just naming something, you know, and not saying that they're doing bad things at the moment, but if the wrong kind of person is in the government, and if it's a dictatorship instead of a democracy, then you know, then this technology will be used against you, and I think already also in our democracy, we're giving away so much of our freedom in a way, because you're being, through algorithms, you're being pushed in a certain way to how to think and what is real news, what is fake news. We don't know anymore, so it's a danger of this time. Well, I must say that, you know, all the highlights, of course. The first time you do something new, you get a golden record. And so these things are always like milestones for us. And I must say that in the past, I maybe appreciated it not as much as I do now, because at that time was the one golden record after the other, and everything was going very quickly for us. But nowadays, yeah, you know, and especially one of the things that I remember most is how we got through the metal to a more mainstream audience, not because we felt that was important, but the way it happened was really special, because it was a vote of the audience, of people from the countries who were voting for us on a TV program, TV program called The Box, and you could put up your video up for selection, and they would pay a small amount to see that video, because no one wanted to play us on the radio, nobody. And because people liked the song, they had to play us at a certain point. And that's how people got to know us more and more. And that was very special. I think that's the biggest compliment you can get. If people really love your music so much, they take the effort to vote for you, although people won't play you on the radio.
Classic 21. Écoutez l'original.